The Pratt & Whitney PW4000 is a very popular family of jet engines. It's been in service for over 30 years and has had many different variants developed for aircraft like the Airbus A300, A330, Boeing 767, and 777, among others. But in recent history, one particular variant of the PW4000 has made headlines for all the wrong reasons, this being none other than the PW4000-112, the variant made exclusively for the Boeing 777. Last year, over 120 planes were grounded around the world following major incidents involving this engine type. After over a year of being grounded, news has finally broken that the necessary fixes have finally been made to these engines, and many once grounded 777s will soon be returning to the skies. So with that being said, let's get the video started and discuss this matter further. On February 20th, 2021, United Airlines Flight 328 experienced a major engine failure as it climbed out of Denver bound for Honolulu, causing significant damage to the 777's number 2 engine. Preliminary examination of this affected engine revealed that two fan blades were cracked as a result of metal fatigue, which in turn caused the failure. As a precautionary measure, Boeing requested all airlines operating PW4000-powered 777s to immediately ground these aircraft. This request affected 128 planes across 6 airlines: United Airlines of the US, Japan Airlines and All Nippon Airways of Japan, and Asiana Airlines, Korean Air, and Jin Air of South Korea. It's been over 13 months since these aircraft were grounded, so what exactly has changed? Well, the best news here is that the necessary corrective measures on the 777 PW4000 engines have been made. And these measures have been deemed satisfactory by regulators here in the United States as well as Japan. No word on South Korea yet to my knowledge, but I did recently hear that Aviation Airlines was planning to return their 777 fleet to service very soon. Their 777s are all powered by PW4000 engines, so I'm assuming that the South Korean regulators have also approved the recent engine fixes. So now let's get into what the fixes themselves actually are to these engines. Really, the most significant fix to these engines, as reported by Clement Charpentreau from Aerotime Hub, is that the engine inlet has been structurally reinforced to withstand fan blade failures. The bulk of the engine failures involving the PW4000 had to do with fan blade failures, which then caused damage to the engine. Therefore, it's great news that a fix has finally been made to the engine inlet, so that in the unlikely event of any future fan blade failures, the results won't be as catastrophic. The second major fix comes with regards to the inspection process, more specifically the ultrasonic and thermal acoustic imaging that's used to inspect these fan blades for cracks, etc., will become more repetitive. That's great news, as previously, Pratt & Whitney came under stark criticism for their engine inspection procedures, and one key critique, among others, related to the fact that the inspections weren't being done regularly enough, and I'm sure you can see why that would be a problem. So those were the developments with regards to the engines themselves, but what about the airlines that use these engines on their planes? As of now, all but one airline will be returning their previously grounded 777s to service. At their peak, Japan Airlines operated 46 Boeing 777s, with 22 of them being powered by Pratt & Whitney engines and mainly used for domestic services. After these planes were grounded last year, Japan Airlines soon announced they would just permanently retire them 1 year earlier than what was planned initially. So these planes were on their way out eventually, they'd be replaced by the A350. But because they were being grounded indefinitely, the airlines said they might as well just get rid of them now. Aside from Japan Airlines, all the other carriers are planning to return their PW4000-powered 777s to the skies over the coming months. This is great news for airlines like United, who saw 52 planes grounded as a result of the engine issue. Let's briefly calculate just how many seats United was missing out on with these planes out of the picture. Out of these 52 grounded 777s, some were used for domestic flights like those to Hawaii, while others were used for international flights. The domestic 777s had capacity for 362 people, while the international 777s had capacity for 276. The median value between 276 and 362 is 319, so multiplying 319 by 52 gives you 16,588 seats that United was missing out on, and that's an underestimate, so that number is actually much higher in reality. Needless to say, United really needed these planes back in service to meet both their goals and the rise in passenger traffic. So I'm happy to see these planes finally coming back. The information given in this video was simply based on my understanding of the matter. If I misspoke or gave any wrong information, please forgive me as I'm just a college student studying aerospace engineering who's genuinely interested in this kind of stuff. Let me know what you think of this news, and if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for more content. But before I leave, I wanted to share some footage I've never shared before. It's footage I've been holding back for over a year now, and it's actually of one of the currently grounded, soon-to-return United 777s flying over on its way to long-term storage, or I should say, indefinite storage in Roswell. These video clips were filmed just weeks after these planes were ordered to be grounded, and I was waiting for the right time to show you all these clips. They're really nothing special, but I still hope you find them interesting. I'll stop talking now, take care everyone, and enjoy this somewhat historic footage. So that right there is a United 777-200. It's flying from Newark to Roswell. And that's one of the 777s equipped with the Pratt Whitney engines, the ones that have been involved in the recent engine failures. So presumably this one's probably headed to Roswell for long-term storage. Either that or it's getting repainted, I'm not too sure, but it's one of the only 777s with the Pratt Whitney's active right now. Or airworthy, I should say. So, very, very cool to see that.